All right, that's a spontaneous sharing. As always, I do not plan it. So that was this really important realization I want to share right now. As let's say that I was looking for one person, which I personally did not know, but I heard about the action that this person did that was violent action. And I felt like, I understand that people who do this, they come from this place of pain, fear, and separation. I know that I still have this in me too, so I wanted to integrate it. And I wanted just to energetically, harmonize my own attitude towards this person. So I was looking for this person, and I actually found another person with almost the same name, but that another person was doing something truly different. The first one was lost, depressed, and in a dark place. The second one was doing their own thing and really enjoying it, really being good at this and creating something completely different vibe. Let's say that these are like two, sides of the same coin, meaning that they represent two opposite sides of the same coin. And I was thinking like, without this first person, I probably wouldn't get to know about the second one. I know actually I could get to know about the second one, but it happened as it happened. I found the second one because of the first one. And the first one is, as I said, it's that person's a really dark place, really dark place. And I was thinking like, that's how it goes. Like without distraction, without this side, there is no creation side. And integration means that you actually you stop dividing them two in your consciousness, and you just harmonize them both, unless it feels harmonious inside of you. And that's how it all starts. No rejection of the dark side, no running away from the dark side, owning the dark side, embracing the dark side, dying in dark side in order to be reborn in the light side, and actually to put them both together, because they are not separated. We just live here in the illusion of separation. We just think that we're separated from everybody because we have bodies, but on a thinner level, on an energetic level, we all are one. We're not separated. It's not just words, it's just, the way it is. And it's like contrast. And it's like if you really see how it all goes and you learn from this and you see how just it all is really connected, and if you're really honest with yourself, you cannot really be, how this word is, hypocrite, I don't remember how to pronounce it, but it's basically someone who just lies, really just lies to himself or to herself, who really do something. Well, you got it. So, if you're really honest with yourself, you cannot be a hypocrite anymore, as you really understand that the dark side is in you as well. You're not an angel, like you are, but at the same time you are the so-called demon, which for me, angels and demons are just a quality of energy. Like angel energy, angelic energy is simply energy of unity, of love, of freedom, of joy, all that. Like ecstasy, like natural ecstasy of just love and blissful being, existence, and consciousness, awareness, mindfulness. Demon energy is energy of separation, fear, pain, anger, violence, and all that. And here in this dimension, we just, you know, explore them both in order to harmonize them, balance them, and finally come from this micro consciousness to macro consciousness, where micro consciousness is based on separation and macro consciousness is based on unity. And as I feel, a lot of us, we've been, you know, there and here, and we know how it feels. We've been really separated from our bodies. We haven't even living in our bodies. We haven't been present in our bodies consciously. That's how it was in my case as well. And now we're actually feeling like finally we are present in these bodies. The whole treasures package now is different. Considering this understanding of the unity, it's not just words, it's just, you know, how it feels inside. And so I resonated with both of these people in a different ways. With the first one, who is on the dark side, I resonated because I understand the place where this person is coming from. It's a very dark place. I know it. I cannot judge someone because I know how it feels. But, you know, I'll be hypocrite if I'm going to judge this person. But the cat is scratching the door. I can hear it. But I was there, and I'm still, you know, sometimes there, because I call it low state. Low state is when you have this you know, ascension symptoms, when you just splash out anger, pain, and all that has been suppressed earlier. Not only during this incarnation, but also during the past incarnations. So I was there, and I understand where this person is coming from. Very dark, lonely, cold place, like hellish place in the consciousness. At the same time, the second person was totally different, was really light, warm. At least that's how I felt this person. And what that person, second person, creates is very, very beautiful too. It's very, very... It's like it's something about unity, it's something about joy, it's something about just this very, very different energies. And you know, it's just such a great example of how one side exists with another one, how they coexist unless we consciously integrate them and balance them. And finally, the same as we balance feminine and masculine energies in us, the same as we balance inner child energy and inner adult energy, the same as we balance inner monster and inner saint, all that, you know, it's like inner beast and inner feast, and we just balance them, you know. And they cannot really be friends, you know. They're like exist on different sides of the coin. Inner beast lives in mental hell, and inner feast comes from this realization of unity. But our like one of the artists I'm going to speak about myself. So one of the things that I'm doing here in this dimension is I'm actually integrating them both. I'm actually harmonizing them both. I'm understanding inner beast, and slowly but surely I'm transforming this part into wisdom. And once there's wisdom there, it's becoming inner feast, because if something has been enlightened, it cannot go back to the dark state of existence. It's just two different vibrations. And it's like the whole spectrum is getting harmonized, and it's a contrast, and it's getting one palette. And you become this artist that you, and you consciously, you realize yourself as an artist. Before this integration, you would realize yourself as a canvas, I guess. You couldn't realize that actually you are an artist. So now that's how it all goes. And that's something truly beautiful. And I just, first time in this incarnation, I feel, and actually I feel like it's not, it's like the first time during long period of incarnations, I feel I'm doing something truly important. I feel it from the inside. I know I don't need to confirm it from someone from the outside, because I feel like all my cells vibrate. They know exactly what it's all about. So, and it's just, it's something that I wish everybody could feel, but I cannot force or hurry someone. It all happens in the appropriate moment for everyone. Everybody will be here eventually, because we evolve. And I just understand if something feels really scary or disgusting for me in this incarnation, there is a huge, it simply means that in my past incarnations, I've been doing something like this. Otherwise, I wouldn't resonate with that. It's like the consequence. And if I'm still in this, it's disgusting, I cannot transform it into, yes, wow, you know, it's again two sides. If I feel it's disgusting, I cannot really transform it into something that feels amazing. Or let's say if I feel something is really unhealthy, I cannot transform it into something that feels healthy. So if I feel something and it's really disgusting for me, it means that it's a consequence. So I own it, I embrace it, I face it, I work with it, I integrate it, I understand it. And then it feels harmonious inside. I feel like, no, I understand. It's not my thing. I don't want to do this anymore in this lifetime, and never ever, because I know how it feels. I've been there, but I'm not a judge to anyone. You know, I'm not a judge to anyone. It's like the one who raises the sword is going to be killed by the one. I know I actually translated it in a distorted way. I just translated it literally, because I heard this phrase in Russian. I have no idea how it sounds in English, but basically says that if you are the one who, you know, who is doing something, that you're going to have the reflection on that. Not because of some sort of, just so-called evil karma thing, but just because karma simply means consequence. As I said, karma is a trace that you leave in front of you. It's not like something that you leave behind, actually something that you leave in front of you. So it's karma, it's like the trace that's going to be waiting for you in your next incarnation, or your next day, or next month, or whatever. So, I only wish everybody to wake up to this beautiful realization. And as I said, I cannot force anyone, so what I'm doing is I'm balancing myself. And if I really feel like, I want to wake somebody up, then I have to again balance myself. because this process is, you know, it's not a, it's sacred, and it's not about just slap my fingers and everybody is doing what I want. No, it's, I have to respect, you know, that that's the path. It's hard. It's hard, especially if you see this, you know, what's going on the planet. You want everybody to be awake so we could finally co-create and create peace here instead of war. But that's really interesting. Everything that is created here as war and lack and absence of health, diseases, all that, it all has been created on a level of separation, fear, and pain. So it all has to be healed on a different level, of unity, respect, and joy, and health, and abundance. So it means that if I hold these energies inside, and one of the expressions would be I'm trying to wake someone up, it means that I still have to balance myself. No, it happens in a proper moment for everyone. And violence is not a property here, because to wake somebody up, somebody who wants to stay asleep, is violence. They're going, once they're ready, they're going to wake up. I know, because I was there, so I have to respect that. So it all is, you know, everything that is a problem is be has to be solved on different levels. Like on one level there is the problem and no solutions left, and the second level is the problem and solutions. On the third level there is no problem. When consciousness travels and evolves to this third level, it's going to be, you know, solved in a blink of an eye. The hardest part is when you really realize that everything is good. All we miss here, truly miss, is our co-creation. People compete with each other instead of co-creating. That's the only thing, the separation. It has to be healed. And here we have to stay, you know, wise. It's hard. But I see no other, how to say this, I see no other solution. All right, it's 17 minutes. They just slipped for me like just 1 minute. Time is different now, so time actually doesn't have to be compartmentalized. It doesn't have to be, you know, fragmented. It doesn't have to be cut to pieces. Because if we perceive time as some sort of line, we deceive ourselves. But finally, I feel like how my consciousness just expands, you know, wide enough in order to perceive time as a spiral. But that's another topic. Don't wanna mix topics. I try to make videos, you know, short enough. Okay.